The town of Bern is well known for its traditional fountains, most of which were built in the 16th century. There's one, though, that looks quite different from the others. It's a concrete column overgrown with algae, moss and grass. It's by the internationally renowned German and Swiss artist Meret Oppenheim, who came to live and work in Bern in the 1950s.
She was already in her late 60s and early 70s when she made that fountain, so it was in a way a mature work, but of course it was significant because it was a public work, it was a public commission, and it was an honor. She tried to balance out opposites, like the stability and the harshness of this column made from stone, and then the plants growing around it. It was like building a bridge between nature and the town or architecture.
The fountain stands at Waisenhausplatz, a public square in the centre of Bern. It was inaugurated in 1983, only 2 years before the artist's death.
I remember when I first heard about it and then came to see it, I still lived in Italy then. It was quite a visual shock, and I thought, wow, the Bernese are courageous.
Courageous indeed. Actually, the design caused some controversy at the time. Some residents even signed petitions to have it removed. And then there were problems with the plants. After the city gardeners failed to get anything to grow inside the water channels as planned, they called urban ecologist Klaus Ammann for help. Ammann glued moss to the wall of the column, and the channels were inlaid with a grid to prevent plants from falling out.
This is the yellowish one which I glued to the naked tube, and after 2 years it started to grow, and this one came spontaneously. But both are highly specialized mosses which need trickling water. Here this slimy things, these are algae. It's a rich flora here. When you take the microscope, you find lots of good things.
According to Ammann, the fountain hosts over 100 different plant species. Almost all grew spontaneously. And while the plants grew, the fountain also grew on the public. Today, it has become a part of Bern, and many inhabitants are even proud and identify with it. But the story doesn't end here. Over the decades, limestone protuberances built up on one side of the fountain. There are fears they could break off and harm people. The city of Bern, which owns and maintains the fountain, will eventually have to do some restoration work on it. But how? Can the chunks of limestone just be removed? Or would this be destroying part of the actual artwork? Some would like it to be restored to an earlier condition, while others would prefer leaving it as it is, believing that this is what Meret Oppenheim wanted.
From her other artworks and from the rest of her oeuvre, I see that transformation is really at the core of her artistic thinking and of her works. So for me, in a way, to change it or to try to bring it back to a former primal condition is, for me, would be the wrong decision.
I called her once in the middle of the debate and asked her point blank, what do you really want? And she said, well, that's nature which will decide what will happen with this fountain.
But there are also different opinions.
I'm pretty sure she wouldn't like it the way it's now, because even though she was an artist, she loved nature very much. She was also someone really precise and rather meticulous. She would write little notes on everything. She would prepare quite precise drawings.
And Lisa Wenger has another personal experience that makes her doubt whether Meret Oppenheim really wanted her fountain to grow wild to this extent.
There was her house in Ticino, in Carona, and on the house, or on the facade, there is ivy. And the ivy has a very specific frame, shape. And she would have it cut and very precisely all the time. So if she hadn't been so precise, she would have let it grow and go with the flow. But to me, that's an indication.
How and when exactly the fountain will be restored has not yet been decided. The involved parties and experts will meet shortly to discuss possible solutions.